श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तः पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवत् व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां ओं ब्रह्मानंदं परमसुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वंद्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यम् एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वधी साक्षिभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। सहनाभवतु सहनं भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। महान अजह आत्मा, आत्मा इज कॉल्ड महान एंड अजह, एंड इट इज सेड दैट वन हु नोज दिस आत्मा बिकम्स मुनिर भवति, बिकम्स अ मुनि, न तो कर्मी भवति मुनि भवति। He becomes a contemplative person, goes within himself. Muni means mananashilvan, becomes mananashilvan. And it is said that for knowing this, he, if required, leaves home. Now, this is important. In our scriptures, there is talk of nivritti marga, pravritti marga. What? The path of renunciation and the path of activity. Now, the question is, can we do both together? That is what we would all like, right? We want to know that only. Thodi pravritti, thodi Yuruti. Can we do that? Now, see, there are four purusharthas. Purusharthas, goals of life. So, which are they? Dharma, artha, kama, moksha. All of you familiar with. Now, so they said in the brahmacharya ashram, you should have the goal of what? Dharma. Only dharma. Then, brahmacharya means student life, basically. Dharma. Then, after that you have to have what? When you are a grahasthi, three goals. Dharma, artha, kama. Artha, kama also. Artha means getting security, wealth, earning, etc., etc. Kama, fulfilling all your comforts and luxuries and whatever that is, pleasures, and it's all allowed. Fine, nothing wrong. And dharma. Dharma yukta artha kama. It should have this. The artha kama should not be adharmic. It should be dharmic. That is, dharma is there everywhere. Then, when you become a vanaprasthi, so as far as the goals are concerned, artha kama should be left, dharma moksha is the goal. What? Dharma moksha. That is why I love the motto of our vanaprastha sanstha. Atma uddhara jagat hitaya cha. Will you remember this one? What? Atma uddhara jagat hitaya. Atma uddhara, your own self-unfoldment, spiritual evolve. And jagat hitaya cha, serving the world. So that is how you should be. This should be there for everyone actually, even a grahasthi. Atma uddhara jagat hitaya. So when you are a vanaprasthi, when you are a retired person, what becomes your goal? Dharma moksha. Okay, that should be. So you do good. So your personal earning for my own this, for my own, that is over. That is how the scheme of those four ashrams used to be there. Okay. And then final will be what? Sannyas. So in sannyas, what should be your goal? Not even dharma. What? Only moksha. This was the way it was given. It was divided. All the four purusharthas were divided. So dharma, artha, kama, and moksha. So by the time you have matured in every possible way and you are ready for becoming completely introvert, no more extroverted tendencies are there. That is why they said dharma te virati. Remember this. If you have really done dharma all your life, meaning you have done your duties and the good thing and everything, you will have vairagya at the end of it. If you have not had vairagya, means what? We did not do what we... Our vasanas are pushing us and prompting us into a life of pravritti. Have you understood? But it's difficult. It's not very easy for everyone to have that type of a nivritti pradhana life. Okay? You know, even when they retire, then that's why they say continue with dharma and moksha pursuit. At least that you leave. Then stop, you know, that aggrandization for your own self and all that. That part you forget. Then you start becoming a little more, you know, giving for the world and doing everything, actions and all. And actually actively start pursuing the path of moksha, right? So this is one who is ready for this path of moksha. Then for him, what does he say? He says, okay, fine. I don't want even dharma. I don't want even any of this. So what do? I will pravrajanti. What does he say? I'm going to take to a path of total nivritti. Is it understood? Then he says, okay, now I don't want any. And then this very famous statements are there. It is very nice. Etadha smatam purve vidvansaha prajam na kamayante sa prajaya. Kim prajaya karishyamaha. There's a famous statement given in others. What will I do with praja? Praja means if I get married and I'll have children and I'll have this. Kim prajam karishyamaha. What will I do? I don't want to pursue this particular path. I want what? I want to be free of all of this and I don't want to get into pravritti. Because see, once you get married, everyone knows what happens. What happens? Please tell me. Everyone. Yeah. So once you are married, then there is the whole thing is there. You can't. Many times people say, Swamiji, I've seen many people before they get married, they will be very active, they will come for the yajnas, they'll come for this, they'll come for camps, they'll do everything. And then you see them after years together, 20 years or 10 years or 15 years and all. Then what happened? Then they'll say one statement, I got married. Finish. Then you know. I got married. Then after they get married, what happens? Next is what? And the children. And then by the time they make them grow up. And it goes on. You all know. Right? So And then afterwards, many times when their children are weak, they Swamiji Balvihar class for children. next is that. I went to Balvihar when I was small. Now I want my children to go. Till that time in between, what happened? So what is said over here? That kim, this man says, no, I don't want. Man, woman, doesn't matter. Kim prajam karishyamaha. What will I do? I don't want any. I don't want to go into a pravritti mark. Then I don't want to then say, okay, fine. You know, right now, I don't see the need in my life. And therefore, I am not going to go into that. It's not just a matter of getting married or earning or all that. It's a matter of the pravritti pradhana life. Is it understood? It's nothing to do with marriage. Marriage is not a bad institution. It's the best thing that can happen. Wonderful, excellent, nothing wrong with it. I am only saying is when a person has decided, supposing a person has decided that I want to become a doctor, why would he go to an engineering college? Understood? So what will he do? Try to go to a medical college. Why would I want to go to an engineering college? No. You can become an engineer and then also you can become a doctor. A homeopathy doctor or whatever. But why? I want to. Have you understood this point very clearly? So he says, Kim prajam karishyamaha. Why would I want to? This also. And therefore, yesham na ayam atma loka iti. So he says, I'm not going to get what I want. I want atmaloka. I don't want worldly achievements. Then why would I want to do that? So he says, tehasma putreshanayascha vitteshanayascha lokeshanayascha vyutthaya atha bhikshacharyam charanti. Having given up these three eshnas, these are famous. You must have heard about these three eshnas. Eshnas are what? Desires, simple. Which are the three desires? Putreshna, vitteshna, lokeshna. Remember, these are important. Putreshna, desire for children. Doesn't mean desire for children. It means desire for the whole, like a family and, the whole thing. See, many times people, outside they may be sannyasis, but inside the mind they may be real grahasthis. I'm not joking. It is possible. Inside the mind, you can't live alone, you always want someone, you cannot this with this, only when, I have seen so many times. Then the sannyasi all the time, with their parents, every day, every this, continuously. You're a sannyasi, have you seen such things? I have myself seen such cases where you feel, my God, why did you become a... You understand? This... See, to contact... Now, other thing is, there are certain this where they say, no, you should not even see your family, Purvashram family. Certain this are very strict about these things and all that. And certain this, they say, it's okay. But this attachment is something. I used to see Gurudev, his own sister used to be there, his half-sister, and I wouldn't even know. I was in the camp and someone told me so and so. She was just like, what? Any other person. It's not that they don't love them or they don't this and all. Many times people say, can you meet your parents? Something, when this not now, but long back. Can you meet your parents? I said, when I'm calling the whole world as my mother and father, what is wrong with the person who gave birth to this body? What I'm trying to say is, if the mind has not become a sannyasi mind, then what will happen? It becomes difficult for that person. You're understanding? Then they'll form another form of sansar. They will then, you are my father and you are my mother and you are my this and you are that. And then they will keep clinging to them. To call everyone father and mother, every family that I used to stay, because strangers, this is imagine 30, 40 years back and all that, going to houses of strangers and all. So every family I went to, the father and mother, I would, like how I would do when my own father and mother are there, before I left and all, I used to do namaskar to them, says, you are like my father and mother. You have been taking care of me. This whole 1 week I stayed in your house and you were like my father and mother. So I would actually go and what? Prostrate to them. Because they would say, oh my, what are you doing? I said, no, I would do that when I was at home. I have to do it when I'm here. I called you like my father and mother. But not that now you are my father and mother. Khatam. Give me property or something. Ye thodi baat hoti hai. So the mind, important thing is what? Putreshna. Putreshna is this wanting yourself to be perpetuated. Remember, sometimes you can do it in terms of family, sometimes you can do it in terms of shishyas. Then what? I want, if not this parampara, I mean the, they call it what? Nada parampara. Bindu parampara is your family. You know, bachcho, bachcho, bachcho ke bachcho. And nada parampara is what? My shishyas, my shishyas, shishyas, my shishyas. No. Then what are you doing also again? Mentally? This. You get what I'm saying? So putreshana, this perpetuation of our, this. Then what? Vitteshana. Vitteshana doesn't mean wealth, wealth as such. Only it means security, feeling of security that comes through wealth. So what do we have? When I have money, I am well taken care of. Is it true or not? I don't have money or I have people, everything is security. So we buy the security, I've got this one, this one, this one. So the mind is still what? Seeking security only. It doesn't say God is there, he'll take care of me. The mind is saying what? This is there. So this is there for most of us. Huh? So don't think, you know, what you think. It's a normal thing. Most of us have this, I must need the money, I need the this, I need this, you know, so that I can be secure. Vitteshana. And then more and more. With wealth goes power and all of that as well. So that is by lokeshana. Lokeshana is what? This desire to be known, to capture. You know, there are the people who, you know, famous and power and, you know, that. And remember, all these are not wrong, is what they're saying. They're not wrong things, they're not bad things or anything like that. What is being said over here, if you want to become a moksharthi, you have to give this up. That's all. Is it very clear? Yes. If you want to go within, you can't have this goal of having something outside. You can become the most infamous person. So what? I want the truth. I'll tell you, there is a beautiful... These stories are amazing. Not that you and I have to do any of it. It's just stories, okay? Stories in the sense like, and they are there, they're actually things. There was this one lady, she's very beautiful, she's very young and all. She went to the Zen master and says, look, I want knowledge. So he says, sorry, I can't take you. He says, no, but I want knowledge. Can you give me knowledge? He says, sorry, I can't take you. As a student, I can't take you. Then he says, at least give me the reason before you reject me. Give me the reason. He says, you're too beautiful. Why? Because the whole, you know, there's a whole ashram full of my young students and you come here and you're going to get what? Distract all of them. Their mind has to be this and all. You can't say, no, they must control their mind and all. They're young people, maybe. So you're too beautiful. Sorry, I can't take you. She went away. A month later, she burnt her face and came back. She says, okay, now please tell me, what reason is there why you can't take me? I'm not saying we have to do things drastic like that, okay? What I'm trying to say is now she says, look, if that is the distraction, I don't want that. Are you getting the point? The point is not that we have to burn faces, huh? Please, no one is asking anyone to burn faces, okay? This is all not the thing. What the idea is that if I want anything off the world, then I can't get this. If I want this, at least that time, for that time, you have to leave. It's like I want to sleep also and I want to watch the TV also. Can I do that together? We try. What do? We still have it on and in between. It won't work. At one point, what you have to do? You withdraw from that and then you go inside. Is it true or not? Dono saath mein ho sakta hai kya? At least at that time, you have to do it. So for that period, all great saints have done that. That they've taken out a particular time. They said, okay, fine. 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, 10 years. It depends on each one. They've taken out that time, withdrawn from every possible, what? Distractions, pursuits, other things. And then gone inside, been with themselves, pursued the path, And then after that, it depends. Sri Ramakrishna Paramahansa stayed in one place, and Sri Vivekananda, what did he do? Traveled. Swami Tapan Maharaj stayed in one place. Pujya Gurudev traveled. You get the point. But at a point of time, what? Vitteshana, Putreshana, and Lokeshana. Look, this I'm telling you, many times Putreshana may go away, Vitteshana may go away, but this Lokeshana, this name and fame are, very, very, it is interesting. See, we have to watch our minds all the time, because mind is the mind. You don't know what the mind can start suggesting. And I remember once, the net is a big thing now. Yeah. So I really was not, I didn't know much about it, because life was too busy for me to really pursue anything. And I personally had no idea that this was on the net. I had no idea. Then someone told me, I used to walk in the airport and all, and someone says, you are on the net or something like that. And you wonder, then it got me. What I'm trying to tell you is how, these things get you, is what I'm saying. Then this is, if you type out Swamini, your only name comes in. So I said, not bad. Immediately. So I did Swami, and I said, wow, not bad. You understand? Then I said, then after some time, I remember I started doing that, and I said, okay, now how many more views on this particular this? I said, what am I doing? Are you understanding what I'm saying? How easy it is. It's so easy to just, and then I would be, typing out and finding how many more views on this particular, what? Talk or something. This is ridiculous. I hope you're understanding how easy it is, this name thing, it gets to you. What does it matter? Few thousand or few hundred or few lakhs, it just, but no, there I was. Are you getting my point? How many of these young people, they say, I have so many followers. Everyone has followers now. It's so interesting. Which is fine. See, their life is different. It's okay. I'm not saying anything about anyone's life, and nothing wrong. I am only saying, if I want to go, what? Inside, if I want to achieve this, I can't do both at the same time, full stop. Very simple. This, so now you say, no, Swamiji, the ideal will be what? Little bit of this and a little bit of that. At least, can you not give us some in between? Don't keep saying just this or this. No. See, yes, it is possible. At least in a year, take out some time when you withdraw. Is that okay? Yes. What? In a year, take out some time where you withdraw. Now, this is the place where you actually did that to some extent, did you? Can you just nod your head so I'll feel at least better? So, if not anything, you did, right? You did withdraw, and you said, okay, fine, nothing but this. Let me do inside. So you went, and in that 24 hours also, you spend that at least those 4 hours trying to what? You understand? Just nothing but this. Okay, fine, that inside. So this is, so in a year, take out time where you withdraw. And when you withdraw, huh? Because many times people go to camps. These camps are another big, what? Nice social event where everyone is only busy with what? The listening to talk, so nice. And then rest of the time talking. Is it a fact or not? Please tell me. What happens in camps? You and I have attended, all of you have attended. Tell me what happens. Most of the camps. Bolo. In the so-called time when mananam is also happening, what is actually happening? Everyone's making more contacts, and then they are in touch with all the people, and then they're there, and then, last camp you came, and this camp, are you coming next camp, are you coming this then? Yes or no? The whole big sansar, all of its. Are you understanding? So therefore, What is the thing, idea? Sometime in a year, take out. Don't make it one day or something, huh? It has to be a sizable period of time. You understand the importance of this 8 weeks? Yes? 3 weeks was also there intense. You know, I said minimum. You know, people are like that. If you say minimum 3 weeks, they'll come for 3 weeks. If you said minimum 2 weeks, how many people said, Swamiji, 2 weeks? No, 3 weeks is not possible. I said, no. I was firm. I said, no, 3 weeks is minimum. You have to come, otherwise you can't. I don't accept. Otherwise they would have said what? If I had said 1 week, then they would say 5 days. Is it a fact or not? This is typical. Guruji always jokes and says, he's saying it's declared, the camp is 1 week. Then they will come for 6 days. Then they will, on the 6th day, they'll say, Swamiji, my train is a little early, my flight is a little, my this is, my that. Are you finished the thing? No. Does it happen or not? So once a year for a sizable, nice period of time, chunk of time, withdraw. And in a 24 hours sometime, specific time, maybe once or maybe twice, withdraw. Can you do that? Yes? Bolo. Once a year, completely. And if possible, don't come with the husband and wife. No. Go alone. Don't go with the family. You know, for the camp. When you go vacation, you go with the family. You go to Kashmir, or not Kashmir, wherever else. That you go with the family, you go have fun, lot of this. But when you want to do a spiritual sadhana, what should you do? What? Because you're not coming out of your mind frame at all. The same old thing what you did at home, the same person you get up in the morning, same conversations happen, same interactions happen, same. You never manage to, what? Get out of that. So once a year, what? And absence makes the heart grow fonder. So maybe it will help. So you, and in the day also certain time should be what? Once, initially they will, everyone will protest, and at that time only all important things they will start talking, so-called important. So what do? I'm sorry, not available. Whatever happens, I'm not. I know of a doctor, he used to do that. He says, I'm available for emergency all the time, but not this time. They say, how can you say as a doctor? He says, no. And he would be so clear about it. And then he would do 24 hours. He was such an exemplary doctor. Everyone loved him. He was like, anyone would do anything. But he says, this time, after that, I'm available. So, during the day, certain what? What? Time. When? He says, sorry, this is my time. And it's sacrosanct, and I will not compromise with that. At that time, something else is there. See, if there's a real, real emergency, of course, that's a different issue altogether. But otherwise, sorry. So initially, everyone will bring their most petty and silly things at that time. Because the world doesn't like you doing that. Okay, remember that. And always obstacles, always remember Hanumanji's journey. Hanumanji's journey was what? When he started, the first obstacle was from the near and dear. Yes or no? His own father's friend came and said, oh, jara khalo, chai pilo, ye karo, wo karo. Remember that. Always in life, the first and probably the last also obstacle will be from where? From the outside one I'm talking about. So therefore, please be very clear about that. And don't complain about it. It's not that they're bad people and no one is bad or anything like that. Okay? No one's bad. I'm only saying is, it is possible. That this... So... Through the year, certain times, and through the day, certain times. Can we do this much at least? At least, nivritti. Completely. That time I don't belong to anyone, no one belongs to me, I have no relations, I'm not a man, I'm not a woman, I'm no one to anyone. Were you all awake at that time? Right. That time I don't. I have nothing to do with anything. Anyone. Okay? And the rest of the time, fine. Your pravritti maya jivan is there. Okay, so he says, charanti, putreshana, vitteshana. He says, at the end of the day, all these are eshanas. So putreshana, vitteshana, all of them are desires for worldly achievements. Yeah? So if this is there, understood, This is what happens. Now comes very, very interesting. Sa lokeshana ubhehi ete eshane eve bhavatah. Now, can you underline this? Sa esha neti neti atma. Agrihyah nahi. This much. Sa esha neti neti atma. Na iti, na iti. Sa esha na iti, na iti. Now, anytime Atma is talked about, you will always, always, always see it is in the form of negative or negation. Because you cannot say Atma is like this. And therefore, you have to keep saying it is not this, not this. Will you remember this? Now, let us take Ajaha. Ajaha means what? Unborn. See, meaning no birth. Do you understand? Everywhere. Deathless. Timeless. Spaceless. Objectless. Remember that? Beginning of the creation, what was there? Timeless, spaceless, objectless. Don't look at me like that. So every time Atma is talked, you can't talk. Why? Because you cannot point it straight directly. This is like that. If you say it is like that, it becomes an object of this. So all you can do is you can negate the Anatma. It is not this. It is not this. It is not this. This is a story which will make you understand. This is a very important statement. Please underline it and keep this in your mind. Sa esha na iti na iti iti Atma. So, there was a king, and good old days, he conquered another kingdom, and he had heard that there is some people who are belong to the personal bodyguards of that king who were really good. Anyway, he conquered, so he got some of them also, and he says, now you become my guards. Now, one of the guards, his wife, knew that my husband is not killed in the war, but he is in this other kingdom and he is supposed to be the guard of that king. This is what she heard. So now she wanted to find her husband, you know, to this. She realized that I'm not a widow, my husband is still alive. So good old days, women would not travel alone. So she took some other person, you know, who says, I'll take you to, so that you can this. Now very difficult to, you know, because he's gone to some other this, I don't know what will happen. So she's like, went to the court where a lot of people were there. And then that man, you know, said, now, can you see your husband? So in those days, at least, they never took their husband's name or they pointed out and things like that. You know, those sort of things were there. So he had like the king was there, and there were five men guards on one side, five on the other side. So he started asking her, is it that first one? So she said, no. Is it that second one? No. The third one? No. The fourth one? The fifth one? Sixth one? Seventh one? The eighth one? Ninth one? No. Then when it came to the tenth one, she looked at him and she looked down. Immediately from the expression, what did he realize? The tenth one was her husband. Na iti, na iti, na iti. No, everything that could be negated was negated. They knew that he was one of the gods. So all the nine were what? Negated. And then that remained that. Now that, she did not say, this one is mine. Okay. Now, idea is, here is, don't, this is only an example, huh? So, everything that can be possibly negated, when you finish negating, that which cannot be negated is Atma. Is it okay? How do you define Atma? It cannot be negated. So, first you have to negate everything possible that can be negated. So that is why all definition will always of Atma, what is Atma, will always be given as what? Mana, buddhi, ahankara, chittami, na aham, not that. Na cha shrotra jivve, na cha ghrana netre, no, not that. Na cha vyoma bhumi, na tejo, na vayo, not this. Then this is, no, but it is said chidananda rupaha. Satchidananda, such things are said, no? Then that is positive language, na? Satchidananda, have you heard this word, Satchidananda? Then what is this? It is said that Atma is Sat. Then isn't that positive? No. This word Sat is used to negate everything which is Asat. Have you understood that? So the only definition, actually, it is not Asat. But that's it. Then you want to call it something because you have to say something, na? So we say Sat. But there is, it's not Sat or anything like that. We are calling it Sat to distinguish it from Asat. Is it okay? We are calling it Chit to distinguish it from Jada. We are calling it Ananda to distinguish it from that which is Dukkha. When all Dukkha goes away, what remains is that Ananda. Is it okay? So therefore, it's not a positive Ananda. One got Atma Gnana, hey! No, not that Ananda. Because you will imagine Ananda, oh, he will Sadananda, Nityananda, Paramananda. So he'll be what? All the time? You know, some funny idea like that. If he does that, then what will not be, people do? Or it should be put somewhere? Are you getting this point? Yes? So this Atma, na iti, na iti, this is a very, very important thing. So even when we are doing meditation or contemplation or mananam or whatever we are doing, we must always understand, if there is some positive this, I know, that means you don't know. I have understood as an object, you have not understood it. All you have to do is what? Keep on negating and negating and negating. Even experiences negate. That is why, you know, when sometimes we get very excited with some experiences. Oh, I'm tingling is happening. That means it's not Atma. Is it okay? Atma Jyoti. I saw light. Not Atma. Why? Saw it. Not Atma. Have you understood? Bolo. But it was shining. It went. Not Atma. Why? Experience. However great. Arhe, but you know, Divya Sugandha. Very good. Better to get Divya Sugandha than Durgandha. Wonderful, nothing like it, but not Atma. Is it okay? Na iti, esha Atma. This Atma is only understood as what? Na iti. Not that. No, not that, not that, not that. When everything negatable is there, so the one who negates everything has to finally get negated. Is it okay? I, the Jivatma, is negating everything. Is it okay? Who is the one who is negating everything? The Jivatma. When that Jivatma also gets negated, that is the Atma Darshana, Atma Prapti. So remember, as long as it's an I negated, that means there's an I still left, which is negating everything. Is it okay? There's still an I, which is negating everything. जब तक वो जीवात्मा है वो सबको नेगेट करता है ना जब तक तो ये जो जीवात्मा भी जब बाधित हो जाता है तभी आत्म प्राप्ति होती है इज दैट ओके न इति न इति हैव यू अंडरस्टूड द इम्पोर्टेंस एंड द फोर्स सो आत्मा कैन नेवर बी डिफाइंड इफ एट all you can have any this it is in the language of negation and that is by agrahya it is what it cannot be grasped agrahya nahi grahyate because it is agrahya you cannot grasp it ashirya nahi shiryate it is undecayable it cannot be it does not decay does not die does not perish And therefore, you will never experience that. It is ashirya. Nahi shiryate. Asangaha nahi sajyate. It is what? Alipta. Anything that does not get attached to anything. Atma is never attached. Who is attached? Jivatma. Okay, Jivatma is the one that identifies the body, dharma, adharma, people, this, that, and all. Not the Atma. Atma is detached. Asangha yayam purushaha. Atma is asangaha. Na sajjate. Then asitaha nahi vyathate. It does not get unhappy. Atma is never unhappy. Mind can be happy or unhappy. Atma is na pyathate. It does not ever get this. Because its nature is like that. You cannot put any attribute to it, any quality to it. You say Atma is all peace. Is that a quality of Atma? No. When you say Atma Shantam Shivam Advaitam, you say Shantam. Shantam means what? There is no what? Agitation. That's the only thing. Atma is not some Shanta, something. What is there? When all agitations are negated, that is Atma. Is that okay? Uski bhasha kya hai? Janne ki bhasha? Na iti, na iti. Not that. Na iti. This is the very, very powerful statement. Here it is given. How do you know the Atma? How do you realize this Atma? That's explained. Tamuha eva ete na tarataha. Then he says, you have to understand that. Ataha papam akaravam iti. Kalyanam akaravam iti. Once you realize the Atma, you don't have any feelings like, I did papa, I did punya. Even punya? No. Why? Because I am the akarta Atma. Then I don't do anything. I don't do any papa or punya. Now, are you all ready for this little concept of akarta Atma? You have to say yes then. Every time. Okay. So I came and sat down over here, right? About some time back, right? So before I sat down here, I existed? Simple question. Yes. Then I came and sat down. Once I sit on the Vyas Peet, I become a Vakta. Vakta means a speaker, right? So I prayed and all, and then I started my talk, right? So I'm right now what? I'm a Vakta. And what are you? Are you sure? Everyone? Shrota or Sota? Okay. So you are a Shrota, right? So this is a status you gained when? When I started talking, you became a Shrota. Did you exist before that? Yes. What were you? A Shrota. We don't know what else we were, but we were not Shrota till that time, right? That much at least, you know. Before I became a Vakta, what was I? A Vakta, not a Vakta. It's simple, not a difficult thing. Now, when I finish the talk in the few minutes' time, what will I become? A Vakta. Only with respect to the Vyas speech and this lectures and all, I become what? Vakta. Okay. Then I finish my talk, what will I become? A Vakta. So I was a Vakta. I became a Vakta. What? What is the important word? Became a Vakta with respect to the act of talking. Okay. Karta, I assumed the role of a Vakta when I started talking. Main Vakta kab bani? Jab bolna shuru kiya, vani ka upyog hone laga, tab main Vakta. Uske pehle main kya thi? A Vakta, non-speaker. Clear? I was not a speaker. Now I became a speaker. When I finish the talk, I will again become a non-speaker, right? So, I was a non-speaker, right? I became a speaker only with respect to this act of talking. And I will again go back to becoming a non-speaker. So, this avakta, this non-speaker, is it there right now or not there? It's there. It's the background of this speaker, right or wrong? Yes. So the non-speaker is still there. Only with respect to this talk, I'm calling this entity as speaker. Is that okay? Yes. That entity that was there is still existing. But right now, with this act of speaking, I am calling it what? Vakta, speaker. Is it okay? So this is the entity which is even there. Similarly, karta. Karta means a doer. So doer is an identity that I assume. Can you all understand this thing? I become a doer. the non-doer always is there, assumes the role of a doer, and the minute the act is over, it still is the same non-doer. All assumptions also gone. So when you take out all assumptions of doership, what remains? The non-doer atma. ठीक है? सब कर्तापना को जब छोड़ देते हैं, उसको नेगेट करते नहीं थी, तो क्या रहता है? अकर्ता आत्मा ही रहता है. तो वो पाप कैसे करेगा, पुण्य कैसे करेगा? यू अंडरस्टैंड? हाउ विल इट डू एनी पाप, हाउ विल इट डू एनी पुण्य? क्या बात है ना? So it says, na papa karvam, I don't any papa. Na punyam, na kalyanam, likhaya, kalyanam. Ubhe hi eva ete tarati. Na enam kruta akrute tapataha. And therefore, he does not get troubled by kruta akruta, by doing something or not doing anything. Is equally at ease. If doing is there, he'll do something. If not doing it, fine. For us, what? When we do something, we gain. Or when we don't do something, we lose. Sometimes it happens, na? Sometimes when we do something also, it's not that you gain. But if you don't do, you are going to lose, so you might as well do it. Sometimes marriages, na? Sometimes you have to go to the marriages. You don't want to go to the marriage. But if you don't go, you are in trouble. So what do? This is apki hazri deke aate hain. Is it true or not? Likhwa ke aate hain ki aa gaye the. Otherwise they won't come for my daughter's marriage, so then I must go for their daughter's marriage. Something like that, na? So when I'm doing something, I'm not gaining anything, but if I don't do, I'm going to lose something, so might as well do it. So for Agnani, by doing, he's not going to gain anything new. By not doing, he's not going to lose anything. Na tapataha. What a beautiful... Can you imagine the state of freedom? You're understanding? This is what is called that total inner freedom. Inner freedom, huh? Outside, nah. It's not that he will not live in the norms of the society or something. He will live by the norms of society. But inside, he's a free person. Okay? Hai, but bahar se to aisa hi dikhta hai. You doesn't matter. What is most important is what? To be inside. So, total swatan. That's what exactly. Even so-called bad and good is not affected him. Is not... making him feel, oh, I'm a bad person or I'm a good person. People will keep saying so many things about it. Oh, you are like that, you are like that. He says, you are talking about some entity which you are seeing outside. But I know, as the Atma, I am not, what? Bad, not good. This is that total independence of a Brahmagnani. It's a very beautiful state. Very beautiful state. This is a nice big mantra. Now, last few mantras are there. Actually, some 3-4 beautiful mantras we will see now in the next 1 or 2 days. We will be having time, and that time we will see. Beautiful chapter. Kya gyan hai. Unbelievable.